What is up, Trainters? Ludo here, back with another fabulous episode, and I finally challenge you to a Pokemon Go battle! So that is right, PvP has been officially announced with their press release giving us all the information. We also have some game footage from the guys over at IGN who actually got to go over to Niantic headquarters and test the new feature in the game itself. Super exciting stuff. Let's get into it. There's a lot to cover and there's a lot to speculate. So let's get into this gig. First off, we are just going to read their official press release that they did with their website. From encountering and catching your first Pokemon to assembling a powerful team to take on legendary Pokemon in raid battles, you have certainly built incredible skills as a trainer over the last 2 years. Are you ready for the next big challenge? Show off your skills against others with trainer battles coming soon to Pokemon Go. Beginning this month, trainer battles will allow you to challenge a friend or another trainer at any time. Challenge another trainer using a battle code, assemble a team of 3 Pokemon, and see who comes out on top. When trainer battles are completed, both participants will receive great rewards, including a chance at a rare evolution item. In order to ensure an even playing field, trainers must compete in the same trainer battle league, which determines the CP limit for participating Pokemon. Strength alone will not ensure victory. Whether you're battling a Caterpie or a Mewtwo, the clever and more strategic trainer will have an advantage. Battles are fast-paced and real-time, so don't expect to wait your turn. Your selected team of Pokemon will be able to execute their fast attack and charge moves. In preparation for battle, you even will be able to use Stardust and Candy to unlock a bonus charge attack for your Pokemon. Timing is important. If you use your head and keep an eye out for your opponent's move, you may be able to deploy a Protect Shield to save your Pokemon from critical damage. But you only have a limited number of these shields before your Pokemon will be left defenseless. While trainers will usually have to be nearby in order to initiate battle, Ultra and Best Friends can challenge each other from any distance, so near or far, you can battle with your closest friends. Looking to learn the ropes or sharpen your battle skills? Team leaders Spark, Candela, and Blanche are eager to test your bravery. You can earn rewards once a day when training with a team leader, including Stardust to help power up your Pokemon. Work toward earning an Ace Trainer Medal, which is something they're bringing back for those of you who are new to the game. So those who are long game players, the Ace Trainer Medal's coming back. It's up to you to get your Pokemon into shape. The only way you'll become a trainer battle master is to get out there and go. So there you have it. That is their official press release for this. So much information in that. So many cool, new, exciting things. First, shout out and link below for the video description of the IGN guys who went over and got us actual game footage. One, you get 2 charge moves by unlocking with Stardust and Candies. Along with that, these charge moves have animations. I'm very happy to see that in-game. That is something that we see very common in the newer handheld games, so I'm excited to see cutscene animation type stuff with Pokemon Go. Love seeing that. Also, with the trainer leaders being something you can battle, maybe they're going to be getting 3D models and 3D aspects to them as well, just like we saw with Professor Willow. So I'm also excited about that. Instead of it just being a flat, really good 3D looking flat map image, it will be an actual 3D model, hopefully. With those trainer battles, we get 1 reward a day from our leader, and then separate of that, you can do 3 trainer battles a day to earn rewards. After that, it is, as we can assume, unlimited amount of trainer battles, but you can only get rewards 3 times. Along with that, we can do remote battles with our ultra and best friends. That is fantastic to hear, because that hints towards a further battle system of like complete Wi-Fi, complete random, just throw two random people in and see how you do. Kind of like what we see with the handhelds. Again, with this battle system, we have so many viable Pokemon to use now. Oddly enough, Ditto and Shedinja will not be included. Shedinja, not sure so much why, but Ditto, because its CP can change, especially when it changes form, it has the chance of being under the bracket and then going above the bracket, and that's why I assume they just cut it out of there, because that could happen and they want to prevent that. So, no, unfortunately, you can't use your Dittos or your Shedinjas, because, you know, no Wonder Guard right now either, so. And as we thought, there's not necessarily a dodging, but there is a shield system. You get two of these shields to use per battle, so you need to choose wisely when you use them. And you can use them, and you'll be allowed and kind of alerted when you can use them when the other opponent is using their charge move. The shield will deflect a majority of the critical damage, but not all. You have the ability to also switch out with your Pokemon at any time, so that's fantastic as well. And then last but not least, really, the reward. So we know you'll probably get XP, probably some Stardust, and probably some other balls or something, but the main attraction is evolution item, which includes a Sinnoh Stone. So, super exciting to see this feature finally into the game. It is the same tap-tap-ish system that we're used to with a few new tweaks and features, so I'm excited. It's not the total battle system rework we were looking for, but it's one step closer to it, so I am happy. But now, let's talk this IGN video. So, there are a couple things I personally noticed in this video. One of them specifically is Garchomp was being used, Regigigas was being used, and when he switches to using Smeargle, you also see a Heatran, a Heatran, whatever it's pronounced, in his other options as well. I understand that they went there and featured this new feature, and they got a glimpse at it, and they might have gotten their own device version or whatever with these Pokemon in it. But either way, they're in someone's game. They're in the coding. They are there. We only have to just wait. So that is super awesome and exciting. I can't wait to see those. Regigigas is one of my favorite Pokemon, so I can't wait to see that one in game as well, especially. And then Smeargle, we have all been waiting for that one. And that is like one of the last ones the majority of us need for our Johto decks. So please, Niantic, give it to us. Another thing I noticed was, I already stated it earlier, that attack animations. The fact that you, when you're charging up your attack, you get this animation that, you know, I mean, it's just super simple, but still, it adds that little bit. It just adds that little bit to it, and it makes it so much more interactive, so much more quality looking, instead of just this tap, 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 woohoo, I won. You know, you also have your little guy jump at the end when you win, and who knows, maybe we'll see 3D models of the trainer leaders, Candela, Blanche, and Spark. That would be super cool as well. And then, not shown in the video, but we do know you can use your legendaries and your mythicals in these battles. So, especially in the Master League, where there's no CP limit, you could probably use your Mewtwos, of course. But, you know, your lower CP'd Mewtwo that you maybe haven't powered up yet, your lower CP'd Melton, or your lower CP'd Celebi, those are viable options now that actually have validity and solid ground to them with the correct movesets and make them. How do I put this in a term of, so in the handheld games, we're basically used to every single Pokemon being able to accomplish great things. It's all a matter of how you train it and the moves it has, its nature, its IVs, its abilities, all those things matter. And we're getting a little closer to that, where each Pokemon is becoming a little bit more important instead of being completely irrelevant. So that itself is something exciting to see, and I can't wait to start using some of my other Pokemon on a more constant basis. Aside from that, there is no word on date release. There's no word on how much Stardust or candies you get in rewards or how much it will cost to unlock this second charge move. None of these things are known yet. So still more, just a little bit more information to come, I guess, as they put on those final touches to this new feature coming into the game. So guarantee you we are going to see a update drop before this drops. So when you see that update, that's when you really want to start get going. But that's about it for now. Get the hype train going. You can. It's officially announced. It's coming. It's here. Just like they do when they release a gen or new Pokemon, they kind of announce it first and then they release it within the following days. So get excited and get ready because you and me gonna battle. Well, I mean, if we're ultra friends or great friends or you're nearby, more reasons to add people and build up that friendship as well. But realistically, that is about it. That is all the information that we know as of yet. So stay tuned, get excited, but we're gonna wrap it up here. So please scroll down, give me that like. This is super exciting. You know, maybe consider subscribing if you're not, because there's gonna be some battle videos coming soon, and you know you wanna see those. And then of course, if you are already subscribed, be sure to hit the notification button next to the subscription button so that way you're notified of the next adventure. And we'll see you then, Trainters. Stay fabulous.
Bye.